Hey there, thanks for clicking on my video. I really do appreciate it. And if you like it, please consider hitting that like button. You could maybe even subscribe, if you feel like it. Okay, so with that being said, let's do this. Leonardo Wilhelm DiCaprio, better known to his friends as Lenny D or Leo, is a famous actor and producer. He's 5 foot 11 inches tall and weighs around 165 pounds, with blue eyes and blonde hair. At the end of 2020, Leo was thought to be worth an estimated $260 million. Leonardo DiCaprio was born on November the 11th, 1974, in Los Angeles, California. His father, George DiCaprio, was a writer, publisher, and distributor of comic books, and his mother, Ermeline Indenburken, a legal secretary. Leo is an only child, and he has never been married either, but he has had a number of high-profile girlfriends, and is currently dating 21-year-old actress and model Camilla Marone. Now, Leo has a large number of homes, most of them being in the USA. Oriole Way in the Hollywood Hills, Carbon Beach, California. Two River Terrace, Battery Park, New York. Palm Springs, California. Paradise Cove, Malibu. Los Feliz, California. And even a whole island, Blackador Cay in Belize. He also has an enviable collection of cars, with an emphasis on environmentally friendly models, including a Fisker Karma, a Volvo XC90 Hybrid, a Porsche Cayenne, and a Tesla Roadster. Leo won the Academy Award for Best Actor for The Revenant in 2016, a category he's been nominated in on four other occasions. His big movie break came as the intellectually disabled brother of Johnny Depp's character in What's Eating Gilbert Grape. Now we come to his biggest grossing movies of all time. Notice the distinct lack of franchise movies here. In 10th place is The Departed, featuring co-stars such as Matt Damon, Jack Nicholson, Mark Wahlberg, and Martin Sheen. Directed by Martin Scorsese, The Departed was produced and released by Warner Brothers Pictures in the USA on October 6, 2006. In the USA, the movie grossed more than $132 million and went on to surpass $290 million worldwide.
I mean, he murdered somebody, right? The guy fucking murders somebody and you don't fucking take him. What are you waiting for, honestly? I mean, do you want him to chop me up and feed me to the poor? Is that what you guys want?
Yeah, well, that might stick.
Will you shut up? We are building a case and it takes time. You know that.
Something's wrong.
The South Boston State Police Force is waging war on Irish-American organized crime. Young undercover cop Billy Costigan is assigned to infiltrate the mob syndicate run by gangland chief Frank Costello. While Billy quickly gains Costello's confidence, Colin Sullivan, a hardened young criminal who has infiltrated the state police as an informer for the syndicate, is rising to a position of power in the Special Investigation Unit. At number 9 comes the chilling Shutter Island, with co-stars Mark Ruffalo, Ben Kingsley, Max von Sydow, and Michelle Williams. The movie grossed $128 million in the United States, and went on to gross over $294 million worldwide. It was also directed by Martin Scorsese, and was produced by Phoenix Pictures and released by Paramount Pictures on February 19, 2010.
You. Could you stop that? Please? Stop that! Please, stop!
Do you know a patient named Andrew Latus?
Do you? No! No!
In 1954, up-and-coming U.S. Marshal Teddy Daniels is assigned to investigate the disappearance of a patient from Boston's Shutter Island Ashcliff Hospital. He's been pushing for an assignment on the island for personal reasons. but before long, he thinks he's been brought there as part of a twisted plot by hospital doctors, whose radical treatments range from unethical to illegal to downright sinister. Next, we have Catch Me If You Can. Leo stars alongside Tom Hanks in this movie, based on a true story, with Christopher Walken, Martin Sheen, and Natalie Bay also appearing. Directed by Steven Spielberg, Catch Me If You Can was produced by Amblin Entertainment and released in the USA by DreamWorks on December 25th, 2002. It grossed over $164 million at the USA box office and topped $352 million worldwide.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away.
The story is about Frank Abagnale Jr., who, before his 19th birthday, successfully conned millions of dollars worth of checks as a Pan Am pilot, doctor, and legal prosecutor. An FBI agent makes it his mission to put him behind bars. But Frank not only eludes capture, but he revels in the pursuit. At number 7 comes a classic remake, The Great Gatsby. Leonardo stars along with Kerry Mulligan, Joel Edgerton, Steve Bisley and others. In the USA, the box office gross for The Great Gatsby was almost $145 million. But worldwide, it totaled over $353 million. Directed by Baz Luhrmann, the movie was produced by Red Wagon Entertainment and released in the USA by Warner Brothers on May the 10th, 2013.
He sent me an actual invitation. Seems I'm the only one. I still haven't met Mr. Gatsby.
No one's met him. They say he's third cousin to the Kaiser and second cousin to the devil.
I'm afraid I haven't been a very good host, old sport. You see, I'm Gatsby.
An adaptation of F. Scott Fitzgerald's Long Island-set novel, where Midwesterner Nick Carraway is lured into the lavish world of his neighbour, Jay Gatsby. Soon enough, however, Carraway will see through the cracks of Gatsby's nouveau riche existence, where obsession, madness, and tragedy await. Now we come to a personal favourite of mine. At number 6 we have Once Upon a Time in Hollywood. Directed by the great Quentin Tarantino and co-starring Brad Pitt, Margot Robbie, Luke Perry, Dakota Fanning and many others, produced and released by Columbia Pictures in the USA on July 26, 2019, Once Upon a Time in Hollywood grossed over $142 million at the box office and went on to achieve an astonishing $374 million worldwide.
I'm Rick Dalton. It's my pleasure, Mr. Schwartz.
Call me Marvin. Put it there. That your son?
No, it's my stunt double, Cliff Booth.
We watched a Rick Dalton double feature. All the shooting. I love that stuff, you know.
Tarantino's Once Upon a Time in Hollywood visits 1969 Los Angeles, where everything is changing, as TV star Rick Dalton and his longtime stunt double Cliff Booth make their way around an industry they hardly recognise anymore. This ninth film from the writer-director features a large ensemble cast and multiple storylines in a tribute to the final moments of Hollywood's golden age. Sneaking in at number 5 is the often referred to The Wolf of Wall Street, another movie directed by Martin Scorsese and featuring such stars as Jonah Hill, Margot Robbie and Matthew McConaughey. The movie was produced by Appian Way Productions and released in the USA by Paramount Pictures on September 26, 2014. It grossed over $116 million at the box office in the USA and went on to achieve $392 million worldwide.
We'll make and more money than we knew what to do with.
We don't work for you, man.
Yeah, my money taped to your boobs. Technically, you do work for me.
What's wrong, Daddy?
But watching you bring home.
Oh, my God.
FBI, any kind of booze you might want?
No, the Bureau forbids us from drinking.
In the early 1990s, Jordan Belfort teamed with his partner Donny Azov and started brokerage firm Stratton Oakmont. Their company quickly grows from a staff of 20 to a staff of more than 250, and their status in the trading community and Wall Street grows exponentially. So much that companies file their initial public offerings through them. As their status grows, so do the amount of substances they abuse, and so do their lies. Following along at number 4 is another personal favourite of mine, Django Unchained. Here, Leo stars alongside Jamie Foxx, Kerry Washington, Samuel L. Jackson and others. The movie was of course directed by Quentin Tarantino, produced by A Band Apart, and released in the USA by Columbia Pictures on December the 25th, 2012. Django Unchained managed to gross more than $162 million domestically, and go on to achieve a cumulative worldwide gross of $425 million.
Good cold evening, gentlemen. Amongst your inventory, I've been led to believe is a specimen I'm keen to acquire.
When I hear the trumpet sound,
what's your name?
I'm on a rise right out of the ground.
Django. Then you're exactly the one I'm looking for.
Hey, stop talking to him.
Calm down. I'm simply a customer trying to...
In 1858, a bounty hunter named King Schultz seeks out a slave named Django and buys him because he needs him to find some men he's looking for. After finding them, Django wants to find his wife, Brunhilde, who along with him was sold, but separately, by his former owner for trying to escape. Schultz offers to help him if he chooses to stay with him and be his partner. In third place, and based on two terrible events in the early American West, is the very primal The Revenant, co-starring Tom Hardy, Domhnall Gleeson, Will Poulter and others. Directed by Alejandro G. Inarritu, I don't think I pronounced that right. The Revenant grossed $183 million in the USA alone, and almost $533 million worldwide. The movie was produced by New Regency and released in the USA by 20th Century Fox Film Corporation on December the 25th, 2015. While exploring uncharted wilderness in 1823, legendary frontiersman Hugh Glass sustains injuries from a brutal bear attack. When his hunting team leaves him for dead, Glass must utilize his survival skills to find a way back home while avoiding natives on their own hunt. Grief-stricken and fueled by vengeance, Glass treks through wintry terrain to track down John Fitzgerald, the former confidant who betrayed and abandoned him. DiCaprio's second biggest money spinner is the strange and intoxicating Inception. Directed by Christopher Nolan, Inception grossed $292 million at the USA box office and went on to top an impressive $836 million worldwide. It was produced by Legendary Pictures and released in the USA by Warner Brothers on July 16, 2010.
Mr. Cobb has a job offer he would like to discuss with you.
What kind of work placement?
Not exactly.
We create the world of the dream. We bring the subject into that dream.
Dom Cobb is a skilled thief, the absolute best in the dangerous art of extraction, stealing valuable secrets from deep within the subconscious during the dream state when the mind is at its most vulnerable. Cobb's rare ability has made him a coveted player in this treacherous new world of corporate espionage, but it has also made him an international fugitive, and cost him everything he's ever loved. And finally, here it is, the biggest grossing movie featuring Leonardo DiCaprio is... Yeah, I know, it couldn't be anything else really. Titanic. Also starring Kate Winslet, Billy Zane, Kathy Bates and Bill Paxton amongst others. Titanic was directed by the great James Cameron and produced and released by 20th Century Fox in the USA on December the 19th, 1997. It achieved an impressive $659 million at the USA box office, but worldwide it topped an eye-watering $2.47
billion. Now hold on to the railing. Keep your eyes closed, don't peek.
I'm not.
Step up onto the rail. Hold on. Hold on. Keep your eyes closed. Do you trust me?
I trust you.
84 years after the event, a 100-year-old woman named Rose DeWitt Bucata retells a story to her granddaughter, Lizzie Calvert, Brock Lovett, Louis Bodine, Bobby Buell, and Anatoly Mikhailovich, while on board the Keldysh. It's a story about her life back on April 10, 1912, on a ship called Titanic. The young Rose boards the departing ship with all the other upper-class passengers, her mother, Ruth DeWitt Bucata, and her fiancé, Caledon Hawkley. Meanwhile, a drifter and artist named Jack Dawson and his best friend Fabrizio De Rossi win third-class tickets to the ship in a game. These are just Leonardo's top-grossing movies, but he has made many more, and some of them probably deserve a mention. Let me know in the comments if there are any Leonardo DiCaprio movies that you love that were not in his top 10.